I just heard from the people in the lobby that the remastered CD version of Leon Carlson's Hippolyte is available in the lobby. I would think everybody who has worked on this film, could they please stand up? And everybody's welcome.
Yeah.
So we'll keep this short and concise and to the point. So here you have a Swedish film made in Sweden. Why? Why? Only the background story of why.
Yeah. Yeah. We tried for many years to do a film with Christina in the U.S. And it didn't happen for one reason or another. And you know, we got to a moment where I. Finally, after you know, knowing Ricard, producer for a number of years through email, that we finally met, and we talked about the possibility of doing something, and you know, it made sense to you know, come here and do it. You know, so we you know started to work with that idea in mind, doing something for Christina and something. Ain't all Swedish films strange?
Swedish films in this film, which is
yeah.
A good thing.
Yeah.
It's like an Easter egg of
yes,
Swedish films.
Absolutely.
I think we have succeeded in making a strange movie. Absolutely.
And Christina, what did you think when these guys approached you? Because this is like a Mexican, Swedish, Finnish, English, American,
Italian.
Yeah.
Got them all. Co-production, yeah, what did you think when they approached you with this idea?
Well, what do I think? I really don't remember, but I've seen your movies before, and I thought they were great, I mean, so, but this is really something else,
yeah.
If you compare with your other movies.
Yeah,
it's hard to remember exactly what you thought.
Mm. Did you feel there was a lot of cultural differences making this film in Sweden compared to your earlier films you made in Mexico and
America? Yeah, the big difference with the making a film in Mexico is that everybody's on time when you shoot the film. in Mexico, there's always delays. Here, everybody was like before the time they were supposed to be there. They were all there. Now it was a very nice experience. I didn't feel a lot of differences. It was, you know, a great group of awesome people, very committed to this. And I was, you know, surprised because I think that this is a type of thing, a very independent type of thing that it's maybe not so common here, but people were into it, like they read the script and they were excited.
But the language must be different.
The language.
The Swedish and the English mixed up.
The English, you know, there was a lot of work there, mostly from Ricard and from that guy over there, Jimmy, who helped navigate the language issues. But it was pretty easy because all the actors were super cool, very easy to work.
Cool. Is there anybody who didn't work on the film, or did work on the film, wants to ask a question. And typical Swedish silence just...
Well, I have one. I worked on the film, but when working on the script, I translated the script. It's like, Alejandro, and then they go out in the pitch black summer night.
Yeah.
And I was like, no. It's right. So we have some cultural differences.
Well, that is an interesting question. Because how much was it more details like that you could see? Well, that's not Swedish, or that would be Swedish.
Yeah,
you know.
There were a bunch of things.
Small things.
Little things, but you know, not much. Yeah, I don't remember super specifically, but it was a world that was, you know, for a few months we were working on those things.
But I think the hardest thing, if I compare with what I have done before, because I haven't done a movie since, I mean, it was about 35 years ago. And then I suddenly got this script, and it was like a book. I mean, it was so much to say. Am I grateful that you have cut some of it? Because otherwise, you know, people couldn't stand my talking all the time.
Christina, because that was actually my next question to you.
Yeah.
How was it? What was it like being on the film set again after all these years?
Yeah. I mean, this movie we made it in 12 days, and I was in the team 9 days of the 12. And after 3 days, you know, I was so tired, so I didn't reflect over anything. I just made my part. I became Lena Carlson after 3 days, and it felt quite good. And I thought that the difference in making movies long ago, I made it in 3 months or something, but this was something else. And I think it was good because you became the person in a good way, I think, because that I was so tired. I just did what you told me to do.
I need to ask, I know that you guys worked with this film over a long period of time. Did you actually, you basically answered the question, but did you shoot it all in one session, or did you come to Sweden several times and shoot bits, or did it all in one?
No, we did everything at once, you know, in 2 weeks work. And then we had 1 day of some drone shots that were missing, but that was it. And then we, last year we came back and we did some ADRs and stuff like that, but shooting was just, I'm not sure if we could have gathered everyone together again, so we had to go and do it.
Could you see yourself working in Sweden again, Michael?
Oh, I would love that. We are talking about that.
could you see yourself working together, you and Christina? I was Christina.
I wouldn't mind to do that. Really, yeah.
Anybody have any questions at all? Anything?
Ja, om jag tar det på svenska om det går bra så kan det öka. Men jo, jag tycker att man kan se lite av Rickard eller Klubb Super 8 i det här. Det är nästan som en hyllning till liksom de här 70-talsfilmerna. Liksom. Så jag är lite, det blir en mix liksom. Så att jag är lite liksom nyfiken på att höra där samspelet. Eller
mellan. The question was that he... feels that there's a lot of Club Super 8 in the film, which is one of the notes that I just jot down as well. You know, it feels like a homage to Sweden and Swedish, you know, alternative culture. Is it? How much did you work on that thing, you guys? Doing that?
Yeah, I mean,
he got all my movies.
Yeah, many years ago, he sent me all of the movies, and you know, I knew a bunch, and you know, it was awesome for me to see all these things, and I wanted to definitely do some sort of homage to that stuff. We featured there one of my favorite films, Catorna. It's there in the television, for instance. Like there's a bunch of references that we tried to put there. We wanted to put a bunch more, and it couldn't happen. Like a couple of people and locations that we wanted to have for specific beats, but.
So actually, there is a question in there which is kind of interesting, that you were talking about the B movies and the 70s movies, but there's also actually a kid from an Ingmar Bergman movie too. So you are both on the highbrow and the lowbrow side of Swedish. You like the both.
But that was early Bergman, so it's still lowbrow.
Yeah,
still a plantation Bergman.
Yeah.
Cool. Any further questions?